In this video, we'll look at how to view and print the key biddings for our key system. We'll navigate to the key biddings page. Notice that the View Biddings button is disabled until you select a group of individual keys. As you move the cursor over the key schema items, the submaster keys highlight in gray and the individual key groups highlight in orange. The View Biddings button will become enabled if you click an orange individual key group. The checkboxes above the View Biddings button let you configure what information will be shown when viewing or printing the biddings. I'm going to start out by selecting all of them so I can point out the individual items when we view the biddings. But first, let's look at what the Include System Info checkbox refers to. If we click the Dormitory Buildings button at the top of the page, we can view additional information about our key system. You can also get to this page using the link in the main menu. Here I can review the information for this key system, and I can change the description if I want. We can also see the key system type and pin size we chose when we created this system, but we cannot change either of these. They are grayed out, meaning they are disabled for editing. If we want, we can add the keyway we will be using for our cores and keys. I'll use keyway D. And I can add the key stamp, which refers to the information stamped on the key blanks at the factory. For example, KS473 key blanks will have the words "duplication prohibited" stamped on them. And we can also know whether we will be stamping the core mark onto the face of the core or on the side. I'll enter side and save. Okay, let's go back to the key biddings page. Let's select the AAB group of 32 individual keys, then click the View Biddings button. Notice that the key biddings have redactions. That is, some of the numbers are blocked out. This is because we're using a trial account. If you see the Buy Subscription button in the header, you are logged into a trial account. I will buy a subscription now so we can see all the key biddings. The pinning charts also have redactions when logged into a trial account. I'll start by clicking the Buy Subscription button. This will redirect me to Stripe.com, the payment processor for key calculus. After entering my email address and payment information, I will click the Subscribe button. My payment will be processed, and I'm redirected to a thank you page that includes some information about the application. Now let's go back to the key biddings page. Notice that now the redactions are removed. I've superimposed the checkboxes over the screen so we can refer to them. First, we have a checkbox for including the system information, which we just looked at, and the submaster description we added when we created our submaster groups. Then we have the control key, the top master key, and finally, the submaster keys. So why wouldn't we always want to include all of this information? Let's say you managed a large key shop and had employees to make keys. Since you might not want every employee in your shop to have access to a top master key or a control key, you could print the key biddings without those important keys. Let's reconfigure the biddings page to exclude those keys. I'll go back to the settings and turn off the control and top master keys. Now, as you can see, your employees have access only to the individual key biddings and the submaster keys. If you don't want to give them access to the submaster keys, you can omit those too. I'll go back to the settings and turn off the submaster keys. And finally, if you don't want your employees to have access to any unnecessary information, you can omit everything except the individual keys. Now let's talk about the buttons at the top of the page. You've already seen the first one. It takes us back to the configuration settings. I'm going to turn on all of the checkboxes again and click View Bittings. The Print All button is used to send the biddings to your printer. From the printer settings page, you can also create a PDF file. Now I'll go back to the settings again and choose a larger group of individual keys. I'll choose the AAC group. If you have a large group of keys, it'll be printed on multiple pages, but the pages will be formatted to prevent splitting any individual bidding table across page boundaries. Next, we have the Print Selected button. If you don't want to print all of the bidding groups, you can use the checkboxes to indicate which bidding tables you do want to print. For example, if you only need biddings 17 through 48, you would check the boxes above those particular bidding tables. Let's do that now. When I click Print Selected, only those two bidding tables will be sent to the printer. Finally, we have the Download All to CSV button. CSV is an acronym for comma-separated values. This button will cause a CSV formatted text file to be downloaded to your computer. You can open the file in a text editor or spreadsheet program such as Excel. You can edit this file as needed. This gives you the flexibility to format the biddings any way you like. You can change fonts, font size, text color, etc. Let's try it now. The file has been downloaded to my computer, and here's what it looks like when I open it in a spreadsheet app. In the next video, we will look at pinning charts.